To import your AWS architecture, just click Import here under the Template banner right from the Documents page. You have two options to import your architecture. We recommend creating an IAM user, but you can always import via command line script if you like. To import via IAM user, just use the script below to create a read-only user with specific permissions. If you need help creating the user, you can use our IAM tutorial located here. Note, we never persist your credentials, but if you'd like more information on our security policy, you can read about it right here. When you're ready, click Next, and then enter your access key and secret key, then click Import. However, if you would like to use a CLI script, select that option as your import method instead. Copy the script below, and then run it against the AWS account you want to import. This will create a .json file in the same directory where you ran the script. It should be called aws.json. If you would like, you can run this script with limited permissions. Next, choose File to upload the JSON file you just created. Again, we never persist your credentials, but if you'd like more information on our security policy, you can easily read about it here. When you're ready, click Import. Whether you chose to import via IAM user or CLI script, you can then choose if you'd like us to auto lay out your diagram for you, or if you'd prefer it to do it yourself manually. Finally, click Finish. And there you go, a full AWS diagram imported directly from your own architecture. This is a diagram generated using our auto layout tool. You'll notice that all of the resources from your architecture are listed out here at the bottom of your toolbox. When you select any of the resources in your diagram, you can also use the Data tab here in the dock to access all of the data pertaining to that resource. You can even add that data directly to the diagram by clicking here. You'll also notice these large red plus icons. They can be used to show connections between different resources. How do we make these connections? Well, Lucidchart imports information about your networking rules and looks for matching inbound and outbound rules to see where a connection could exist between resources. We base these assumptions on a few different kinds of relationships, including load balancers attached to auto-scaling groups and EC2 instances, CloudFront pointing to S3 buckets, security group rules, and etc. You can see those in the advanced settings when you click on the connection nodes, those red plus icons we mentioned before. If you're not sure why there's a connection between two items you didn't expect to be connected, that's because Lucidchart's AWS import draws connections based on security groups and subnets and looks for ports to be open on both sides of a connection. If you're seeing connections you don't expect between items, it's likely that the items have open ports between them. For example, one item may have a port open to send traffic to all IPs, and the other item may have the same port open to receive traffic from all IPs. Finally, again, just note that all of the resources in your imported diagram were loaded here at the bottom of your toolbox. And if you chose to manually lay out your diagram, you can very easily drag and drop all of your resources right onto the canvas. There you go. Everything you need to get started with diagramming your AWS architecture in Lucidchart today.